Hey guys, Dave from Wellsby Roots. Today I just wanted to make a quick video on how to make hardtack. For those of you that don't know what hardtack is, it is a flat bread that's extremely hard and lasts forever. They have two museums in the US that I know of where they have hardtack from the Civil War. It's 150 years old and it's still edible today. It lasts forever. It will outlive you, basically. So it's the soldiers didn't really enjoy eating it. They used to soak it in the coffee to soften it up. I enjoy it. I don't know whether it's the historical value of it or whether it's the fact that, you know, it lasts forever. I don't know what it is about it exactly. I like bringing it with me when I go hunting. I throw some in my pack, and when I'm just wandering through the woods, it's something to nibble on, I guess. It's got some nutritional value. Like I said, they issued it during the Civil War to the soldiers for them to eat. So it's super simple to make. And let's get started. All you need is 3 cups of flour. So 3 cups of flour. 1, 2, and 3. 3 cups of flour. 2 tablespoons, or sorry, 2 teaspoons. 2 teaspoons. Of salt, and you can use whatever salt you want. I'm using pink rock salt just because it's supposed to be healthier for you. So 1, 2, and then 1 cup of water, give or take. You might need a little bit more. So 1 cup of water. Let's stir this up first, just so we can get this mixed around properly. Just get the wooden spoon out and mix this all around before we add the water. That way we don't get clumps of salt in one area and not another. So I have the oven preheating right now, and you want to heat it at, you want to cook the hardtack at 375 degrees. So 375 degrees. And I will put the recipe down in the description. So add 1 cup of water. And we will mix that around. Mix it up really well until it becomes a nice dough that you can work with your hands. There's a lot of flour left over here. I'm gonna take some of that and I'm gonna put it on the board that we'll be working on. And I might add a little bit of water to this. So let's go over to the board. So let's put some flour down here on the board. This flour will just help keep the dough from sticking. I think it's good enough that we can put on the board now. Dump the rest of this flour on here. Try to scrape some of this out of the bowl so we don't waste. And there's your dough. So basically you just want to work this dough. Work this dough until it's no more sticky spots left in it and it's clumped together well. I think that's almost good. Now we're just going to stretch it out some. And you can do this with a rolling pin, or you can do this by hand. Let's get the rolling pin out. I'm just gonna take some of the flour and just kind of put it on the rolling pin here. See if we can get this to form up into somewhat of a square. Be nice. Not be perfect. It'd be nice if you get it somewhat uniform as far as thickness goes. Flour. So all you're going to do at this point is cut this up into, you know, somewhat squares, and then we're going to poke it. Grab a piece of cutter, do it. You use whatever you have on hand. I've done it with a knife. This will be faster. So just kind of cut along here, like so. So then we're just gonna cut them into like squares. just like that. Just like that. Some of these other pieces you can kind of fool around with. You want to square them off a little bit. If they're thick, you can thin them. All right. So then you want to take a fork and you want to poke these. So some of these ones that are a little wider, you're going to want to go right across. So just poke your fork into it like this. That's just going to help it cook thoroughly through. So I'm going to do the rest of these and then I'll show you. Now all I'm going to do is I'm going to throw them on the cookie sheet. Like I said, we're going to bake these at 375 degrees. And we're going to do that for half an hour. And then we're going to flip them. And then after we flip them, we'll bake them again for another half an hour. So prep time for these might be, I don't know, 10, 15 minutes. And then you're looking at about an hour's worth of cooking. There you go. So we'll throw these into the oven. And in a half an hour, I'll show you again. We'll flip them. And then it'll be another half hour. So it's been 30 minutes. So all we're going to do now is just flip them. Stick them back in for another 30 minutes. So it's been another half an hour and the hardtack is done. And that's it. So at this point, I would wait for them to cool down and then stick them in a container and put them on the counter, or you could stick them in a Ziploc bag and store them away. They don't even need to have, you know, be stored into a container or a Ziploc bag, but that's it. So like I said, they're just a nifty little snack to take with you when you're hunting or just have out and about. I have some in a survival bag and sometimes I just eat them just for the have something to munch on type deal. So anyway, hope you guys enjoyed the video, and I don't know, try out this recipe and see what you think, and leave some comments for those of you that have had hardtack before. Maybe you have some different recipes. Sometimes I will add dandelion root to them, dried roasted dandelion root. I will grind them up and put them in the batch just to add a little bit more, you know, nutrition to it. So if any of you guys have some other unique recipes, leave them in the comments. And for those of you that might try this for the first time, put some comments so that we can all enjoy your experience. So anyway, again, hope you guys enjoyed the video, and I'll catch you on the next one. Thanks for watching.